Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is module number 1, Basics of Thermodynamics and Zeroth Law of Thermodynamics. And this is lecture number 4 on module 1. And we recap from the previous lectures. In the previous 3 lectures, we studied about thermodynamic properties, thermodynamic system, quasi-static process. Particularly, we defined the density, specific volume, specific weight, pressure and temperature. We studied about all the thermodynamic property. And in this lecture, we solved few problems on the properties of in the thermodynamic properties, so that we will get familiarity on the equations used for calculating various properties. And the learning outcome, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on thermodynamic properties and the temperature. And we take the example number 1. Classify the properties, whether it is extensive or intensive, and write its unit. A, volume, B, kinetic energy, B, C, pressure, D, stress, and E, velocity. The answer, volume is an extensive property, the unit is meter cube, kinetic energy is also extensive property, which depends on the mass, the unit is joules or newton meter, pressure is intensive property, it is independent of the mass, so the unit is pascal or newtons per meter square, the stress is also intensive property, where the unit is newtons per meter square. And the velocity is intensive property, independent of the mass of the system, and the unit is meters per second. Calculate the density, specific volume, specific weight, mass and the weight of a body that occupies 200 meter cube. If its specific volume is 10 meter cube per kilogram, you take g equal to acceleration due to gravity, g equal to 9.81 meter per second square. So the given data, volume V equal to 200 meter cube, specific volume small v equal to 10 meter cube per kilogram, acceleration due to gravity G equal to 9.81 meter per second square. And calculating the various properties, density rho equal to 1 by the specific volume, 1 by 10 equal to 0.1 meter cube per kilogram, mass equal to M equal to volume divided by the specific volume, equal to 200 by 10 equal to 20 kilogram, weight equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity, which is 20 into 9.81 equal to 196.2 Newton. And specific weight, gamma equal to W by volume, weight by volume, which is 196.2 by 200 equal to 0.981 Newton per meter cube. Or specific weight is also equal to G, rho into G, density into the acceleration due to gravity, which is 0.1 into 9.81 equal to 0.981 newtons per meter cube. So you get the familiarity about the equations to calculate the property of the system. And you have a table here. So the various properties mentioned here, specific volume, density, specific weight, mass and weight of the system. And you are given few parameter, the shaded area. And you have to calculate other parameter. Horizontally, you have to fill the complete the table. So the general data, G is 9.81 meter per second square and volume is 10 meter cube. So for all the 5 problems, G equal to 9.81 meter per second square and volume equal to 10 meter cube per kilogram, meter cube, sorry. And we take the first example, area A, volume is 10 meter cube, G is 9.81 meter per second square and specific volume is 20 meter cube per kilogram. We calculate other properties, density equal to 1 by specific volume, 1 by 20 equal to 0.05 meter cube kilogram per meter cube, specific weight gamma equal to rho into g, which is 0.05 to 9.81 equal to 0.4905 newton per meter cube, mass equal to volume by specific volume, this is 10 by 20 equal to 0.5 kilogram, and weight equal to m into g, which is 0.5 into 9.81 equal to 9.905 newton. And substitution B, volume is 10 meter cube, g equal to 9.81 meter per second square, and rho equal to 2 kilograms per meter cube. We calculate other properties. First one, specific volume, small v equal to 1 by rho, so 1 by 2 equal to 0.5 meter cube per kilogram. Specific weight, gamma equal to rho into g, so 2 into 9.81 into 19.62 newton per meter cube. Mass equal to capital V by small v, volume divided by the specific volume, which is 10 by 0.5 equal to 20 kilogram. And weight equal to m into g, which is 20 into 9.81 equal to 196.2 newton. We take the third example. Volume is 10 meter cube, g equal to 9.81 meter per second square. Specific weight equal to 4 newton per meter cube. We calculate the density. Density rho equal to specific weight divided by the g, acceleration due to gravity. 4 divided by 9.81 equal to 0.408 kilogram per meter cube. Specific volume small v equal to 1 by rho, 1 by density, which is 1 by 0.408 equal to 2.45 newton meter cube per kilogram. Mass equal to volume divided by the specific volume, 10 divided by 2.45 equal to 4.08 kilogram. And the weight W equal to M into G, which is 4.08 to 9.81 equal to 40 newton. And we take the subdivision D, volume is 10 meter cube, G 9.81 meter per second square, mass equal to 100 kilogram. Density equal to rho equal to M by V, 100 divided by 10 equal to 10 kilogram per meter cube. Specific volume small v equal to 1 by rho, which is 1 by 10 equal to 0.1 meter cube per kilogram. And specific weight gamma equal to rho into g, which is 10 into 9.81, which is 98.1 newton per meter cube. And weight equal to m into g, which is 100 into 9.81, which is 981 newton. We take the first subdivision E, volume is 10 meter cube, g, acceleration due to gravity is 9.81 meter per second square. Weight equal to 100 newton. So specific weight equal to gamma equal to weight divided by volume, 100 divided by 10 equal to 10 newton per meter cube. Density rho equal to specific weight by g, 10 by 9.81 equal to 1.02 kilogram per meter cube. And specific volume small v equal to 1 by rho, which is 1 by 1.02 equal to 0.98 meter cube per kilogram. And mass equal to volume by specific volume, 10 divided by 0.92 equal to 10.2 kilogram. And all the five answers are given here. So the value along the diagonal is what the value given here, and the other values are calculated, and the values are given in the table. Consolidated table is shown here. And next example, example number 4, complete the following table if atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal. You are given gauge pressure in kilopascal, absolute pressure in kilopascal, millimeter of absolute pressure in millimeter of mercury, and gauge pressure in meter of H2O. And you are given values along the diagonal, horizontally we have to calculate. We take the first subdivision, A, atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal, gauge pressure is 5 kilopascal. Absolute pressure is atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure, which is 105 kilopascal. And absolute pressure in millimeter of mercury, so 760 into 105 divided by 101.325. So 760 millimeter of mercury equal to 101.325 kilopascal. And for 105 kilopascal, this is 787.56 millimeter of mercury. Next, we calculate the pressure in terms of meter of water column. H2O equal to gauge pressure divided by rho into g, where rho density of water and g is acceleration due to gravity. We are given 5 kilopascal, 5000 pascal divided by 1000 into 9.81 equal to 0.51 meter of H2. So the pressure in terms of meter of H2 is 0.51. We take the second subdivision, atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal, absolute pressure is 150 kilopascal. So the gauge pressure equal to absolute pressure minus the atmospheric pressure. So 150 minus 100 equal to 50 kilopascal. So the absolute pressure in terms of millimeter of mercury, 760 divided by 101.325 into 150, which is 1125 millimeter of mercury. And in terms of water column, pressure, gauge pressure divided by rho into g, gauge pressure equal to 50 kilopascal, which is 50 into 1000, 50,000 pascal divided by 1000 into 9.81, which is 5.1 meter of water column. And we take the subdivision C, atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal and absolute pressure is 30 millimeter of mercury, and the absolute pressure in terms of kilopascal 101.325 into 30 divided by 760, which is 4 kilopascal. Then the gauge pressure PG equal to P absolute minus P atmospheric, absolute pressure minus atmospheric pressure. So 4 minus the 100 equal to minus 96 kilopascal, and the pressure in terms of water column. So pressure gauge pressure will be rho into G minus 96,000 divided by 1000 into 9.81, which is minus of 9.78 meter of water column. So here minus sign is missing. So minus of 9.78 meter of water column. And the fourth subdivision, atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal and PG gauge pressure is 30 millimeter of water column. So the gauge pressure is rho GH, which is 1000 into 9.81 into 30 equal to 294,300 pascal, which is 294.3 kilopascal. Absolute pressure equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure, which is 100 plus 294.3 equal to 394.3 kilopascal. And absolute pressure equal to 760 into 394.3 divided by 101.325, which is 2957.5 millimeter of mercury. And this is what the answer, final answer. So the values on the diagonal, it is given. We calculated all the other values here. So this is what the answer for the problem. And example number 5. The barometer of a mountain hiker reads 930 millibar at the beginning of the hiking trip and 780 millibar at the end. Neglecting the effect of altitude on local gravitational acceleration, determine the vertical distance climbed by the mountain hiker. Assume an average air density of 1.2 kg per meter cube. So there is a mountain hiker, he is climbing the mountain. At the beginning, before we start, at the bottom of the mountain, the pressure barometer reads 930 millibar, and after completing his trip, the climbing, so the pressure is measured as 780 millibar. Now, what is the height traveled by him? That is what the question. And the given data, P1 equal to 930 millibar, P2 equal to 780 millibar, and density of the air equal to 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. And the distance climbed, the pressure difference delta P equal to P1 minus P2, which is 930 minus 780 equal to 150 millibar. So into 10 power minus 3, that is bar, into 10 power 5, that is the newtons per meter square. So the height climbed delta H equal to delta P divided by rho into G, which is 15,000 divided by 1.2, density of the air equal to 1.2 into 9.81 acceleration due to gravity. The answer is 1274.2 meter, 1274 meter. That is what the height climbed by the mountain hiker. Another example, the basic barometer can be used to measure the height of the building. If the barometer reading at the top and the bottom of the building are 730 and 755 millimeter of mercury, respectively, determine the height of the building. Take the density of the air and the mercury as 1.18 kilogram per meter cube and 13,600 kilogram per meter cube respectively. And we are given H1 equal to 730 millimeter of mercury, H2 equal to 755 millimeter of mercury, rho HG equal to 13,600 kilogram per meter cube, density of the air equal to 1.18 kilogram per meter cube. And delta H, the height difference of the barometer is 755 minus 730 equal to 25 millimeter of mercury. And H air equal to, this height is millimeter of mercury, we have to convert into air column, height of the air column. So H air, height of air column equal to density and delta H of the mercury column divided by density of the air. So 13,600 into 25 divided by 1.18, which is 288,135 millimeter, which is 288.1 meter. So the height of the building is 288.1 meter. That is what the answer to the problem. Example number 7. The pilot of an airplane reads the altitude as 3000 meter and the absolute pressure is recorded as 58 kilopascal when flying over a city. Calculate the local atmospheric pressure in that city in kilopascal and in millimeter of mercury. take the density of the air and mercury as 1.15 kilogram per meter cube and 13,600 kilogram per meter cube respectively. And the given data, height equal to 3000 meter, absolute pressure at a distance at the height equal to 58 kilopascal, density of the air equal to 1.15 kilogram per meter cube, and density of mercury equal to 13,600 kilogram per meter cube. And we have to calculate the atmospheric pressure, and atmospheric pressure, which is the pressure of the atmosphere at the ground level, which is absolute pressure plus gauge pressure. So, because when you move in the upward direction, the gauge pressure is decreasing. That is why we add the gauge pressure here. So, the absolute pressure plus rho g h of air. So, the absolute pressure is given as 58 kilopascal. So, 58,000 plus rho g h 1.15 into 9.81 into 3000. This is equal to 91,844.5 kilopascal or 91.84 kilopascal. So, the absolute pressure at the ground level, atmospheric pressure at the ground level is 91.84 kilopascal, and in terms of millimeter of mercury, so HHG equal to the pressure in Pascal divided by the density of the mercury and the acceleration due to gravity, 91,844.5 divided by 13,600 into 9.81 equal to 0.688.4 meter or 688.4 millimeter, 688.4 millimeter. So this is the atmospheric pressure in that city. And example number 8, a basic barometer can be used as an altitude measuring device in the airplane. The ground control reports that barometer reading of 753 millimeter of mercury, while the pilot reading is 690 millimeter of mercury. So the barometer reading, atmospheric pressure is 753 millimeter of mercury and pilot reading is 690 millimeter of mercury. Estimate the altitude of the plane from the ground level if the average air density is 1.2 kilograms per meter cube. So the given data, H1 equal to 753 millimeter of mercury, H2 equal to 690 millimeter of mercury, density of mercury is 13,600 and density of air equal to 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. And delta H, height difference equal to 753 minus 690 equal to 63 millimeter of mercury, and the height of the air column or the height at which the airplane is flying, HCR equal to rho into delta H into of HG divided by density of the air. So 13,600 into 63 divided by 1.2 equal to 7,14,000 millimeter or 714 meter. The height of the airplane from the ground level, it is 714 meter. And the temperature of a body is 50 degree Fahrenheit. Find the temperature in degree Celsius, Kelvin and the Rankine. And this is the answer. Degree Celsius equal to 5 by 9 or 5 by 9 into degree Fahrenheit minus 32. So 5 by 9 into 50 minus 32 equal to 10 degree Celsius. Degree Kelvin equal to degree Celsius plus 273. So 10 plus 273 equal to 283 Kelvin. And degree Rankine equal to degree Fahrenheit plus 460, which is 50 plus 460 equal to 510 degree Rankine. So these are all the answers. So to convert the temperature, given temperature into other scale of measuring temperature. And another example, the temperature of a body is measured to be 30 degrees Celsius. Determine the temperature in degree Rankine, Kelvin and degree Fahrenheit. And this is the answer. So degree Fahrenheit, 9 by 5 into degree Celsius plus 32. So 9 by 5 into 30 plus 32 equal to 86 degree Fahrenheit. And degree Kelvin equal to degree Celsius plus 273. 30 plus 273 equal to 303 Kelvin. And degree Rankine equal to degree Fahrenheit plus 460 equal to 860 plus 86 plus 460 equal to 546 degree Rankine. And example number 11, the average temperature of the atmosphere in the world is approximated as a function of altitude by a relation T atmosphere equal to 288.15 minus 66.5 Z, where temperature T atmosphere is the temperature of the atmosphere in Kelvin and Z is the altitude in kilometer, with Z equal to 0 at the sea level. Determine the average temperature of the atmosphere outside an airplane that is cruising at an altitude of 12,000 meter. The Z equal to 12,000 meter, which is 12 kilometer, is the given data. And using the relationship, T atmosphere equal to 288.15 minus 6.5 Z, and Z should be in kilometer. So 288.15 minus 6.5 into 12 equal to 210.15 degrees Kelvin. So the temperature is 210.15 Kelvin. And these are the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries or comments on the video, you can write to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries and comments. Thank you for watching, and we'll meet again.